Well, it's 5:50. Looks like it's going to be a great day today. Maybe a little bit hot later in the day, but I'm excited. I'm optimistic. I think I'm going to be on the same wide shoulders coming here, so that looks great. I can't wait to kind of get rolling on that. I probably got about another 15 minutes before I can actually load up. So we'll see what today brings. Incidentally, that big bright speck in the sky is not a star, that's Venus. So maybe that's good luck. I got a planet easily visible. In fact, over here, I don't know if you guys can see it, that one right down there is actually Mars. All right, all good. Well, it's going to get hot today. I can feel it. The weather forecast called for clouds. I don't see any clouds. So I know that when 11 o'clock comes, it's probably going to get much hotter than what they forecasted. So I've got to really make sure that I hydrate properly today, especially for a 72, 73 mile day. Miles on these beautiful roads. Nobody on them but me. 18 feet wide. They're awesome. Now it's over. Now I'm on a Highway 81, but still wide shoulders, moderately busy, not really that busy, but it's a great ride. Okay, 30 miles done. Hang on. 30 miles done, 42 to go. I've been riding 3 hours, so I got about 4.5 more hours to go. It's starting to get hot, but I'm well hydrated, and the roads are awesome. I mean, you might see a lot of cars here, but look how wide that shoulder is. It's pretty nice to ride on. Okay, so here's a recap from today. 71 miles. I ended up in El Reno, which looks like about 30 minutes west of Oklahoma City. And it was a hot day. Looks like it was about just over 7 hours on the bike today. And it just felt hot. I wasn't fatigued. My body handled it fine. I stopped very often and consumed a lot of liquid. I consumed about 250 ounces of liquid. So I carry 100 ounces of liquid in my 3 bottles. And I know that I, just in counting, I consumed roughly 2.5 of those bottles throughout the day. And according to Garmin, like I said, Garmin says I should be consuming 246 ounces. I'm going to have to increase that some, because once I get off the bike and I clean up and I shower and I hit the restaurant and I load up, I'm consuming probably another 300 ounces just trying to catch up. And I just feel a little fatigued. Go figure, right? 54 years old and on a bike in the sweltering heat in Oklahoma in getting to be mid-July. So tomorrow is good news and bad news. So tomorrow has 66 miles. So I have less miles to ride, but it's much hotter. Tomorrow is a high of 101 and it's windy. So the lowest wind that I'm seeing projection wise is 13 miles per hour. And it's getting up over 20. So wind is either helping you or hurting you. So I'm not really sure kind of where we stand with that. Maybe I get lucky, maybe I don't. I don't see a whole lot of elevation to play with. But there's also this other thing. All right, tell me if you see something funny. Not what I want to be on crossing the country. So I talked to James over at Fort Recycle and he thinks it's fine. Just keep an eye on it and get it to a bike shop when it's convenient. Well, ideally what I'd like to do is to ride it like it is up to Wichita, Kansas. And then when I'm up there, seek out a bike shop and kind of get it figured out. But I think that's probably 300 miles. So, yeah, we'll see.